When Chiaki Kobayashi gave birth to her second daughter, she quit her job as a doctor to look after her. It had taken 6 years of hard work to get a license to practice medicine, but her working hours were long and irregular, and she couldn't get help at home, partly because the rest of her family are also doctors. She also found she was increasingly doing more paperwork than surgery. However, she finally had enough when her male managers harassed her during her last month of pregnancy.
I had severe back pain, so I asked my bosses if I could use extra days off to start maternity leave a week early. At first they ignored me, and then they criticized me for getting pregnant again with a second child. I cried, but they criticized me in front of my colleagues, including two other pregnant doctors. They said hospitals are short-staffed because of women like me quitting after having kids. They said that wouldn't happen if there were fewer female doctors.
That was the thinking revealed at a top medical school in Tokyo last month, which admitted to manipulating entrance exam scores to keep women out. The gap between men and women is especially big in medicine, where only 20% of all doctors in Japan are female. Female physicians also make 20% less than the males. Experts say the root of this gap is in the country's universal healthcare system. Cheap medical services in Japan are helping people live longer and healthier lives, but it's also putting pressure on hospitals and staff. The Japanese see doctors, on average, more than twice as often as other developed countries. That's why doctors in Japan face difficult working conditions, which has helped create a belief that only male doctors can keep up with a 24/7 lifestyle.
Japan has traditionally forced child-rearing onto women. If more male doctors took part, that could help reduce the burden on female doctors.
To help working mothers, the government is urging medical institutions and companies to provide them with more support, including shorter working hours. But some say that will just increase criticism for male colleagues.
If more doctors work flexibly and take care of their families, regardless of gender, this might stop many from quitting. I think that could help save more lives.
Prime Minister Shinzo Abe has said his priority is to create a society where women can shine. But Kobayashi says unless both men and women change the way they work, having a job and a shining life will be an impossible dream. Mayu Yoshida, TRT World, Tokyo.